Hello and welcome to another legacy, or should I say in this case modern, weirdo. I'm Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet, and I will be your guide, your host, your protector of the realm. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm going to play some modern today with the new Bridgevine deck. I'm playing a little bit with it on stream. I've recorded a little bit for my channel this week as well. The deck is obscenely good and probably won't be around for much longer. I can imagine something from this deck is going to get banned. For those of you who don't know, this is a variation on Bridgevine. Bridgevine is a deck that utilizes both Bridge from Below and Vengevine to create its name and its primary game plan. Vengevine is going to be put into the bin via things like Stitches Suppliers, Instant Neonates, and of course everyone's favourite graveyard enabling card that might be up for a ban at some point, Faithless Looting. We put Vengevines in the bin and then we reanimate them by playing multiple spells. So that allows us to play Gravecrawlers and Carrion Feeders, for example, or Stitcher Suppliers and Instant Neonates to reanimate them. And that's one of our multiple game plans, but it's not our primary game plan. That's what the name comes from, it's not our primary game plan. Whilst doing all of that, we have some ways to sacrifice creatures. Neonates sacrifice themselves, and Carrion Feeder sacrifice other things. Carrion Feeder being a new card from Modern Horizons alongside Altered Dementia and Hogaak. Altered Dementia is our third sacrifice outlet, which also allows us to mill ourselves and our opponents. We can actually mill ourselves to put Bridges from Below into the graveyard out of our deck, and also find Gravecrawlers and Bloodgusts. Once we start to sack things, we make zombies off Bridge from Below, and we can start to grind out and outvalue our opponents. However, that's also only a secondary game plan. Our primary game plan, and the one that makes the deck so obscenely consistent and strong against even several bits of hate, is the new Hogaak. The sleeper hit from Modern Horizons. Everyone said it was a new commander set, and then we see decks rocking up with three new cards. What Hogaak says is that it cannot be cast with mana, and can be cast from graveyard, so you can convoke and you can delve. So you can tap your Vengevines and your black creatures, or you can delve things away from your graveyard to cast him. So ideally, the way we win our best like combo kill is to have two Bridge from Below in the graveyard, a Hogaak in the graveyard, and Altered Dementia in play. What we do is we tap our two creatures in play, whether it be Carrion Feeders, Gravecrawlers, Zombie Tokens, whatever, to play for the two black, and then we delve five away, reanimating Hogaak. We then sack Hogaak either to ourselves to find more bridges, or targeting our opponent to mill them for eight, and that will make two zombies if we have two bridges in the graveyard. At that point, we have a loop. We tap the two new zombies, delve five more cards, and we Hogaak them in the face, or Hogaak ourselves to enable the next delve, so on and so on and so on, ad infinitum. Eight mill each time, so that soon adds up to mill our opponent out. And by the time we finish this loop, we'll have a lot of tapped zombies as well, which allows us to sack those to mill out our opponents. So we have mill plans that get through Ensnaring Bridge, we have like aggro plans of Vengevines and Zombie Tokens to kill our opponents. And that's kind of the deck in a nutshell. It has like sort of three angles of attack that are all closely linked. Now, I was playing Crypt Breakers as my flex slot, this flex slot here, but I was finding that things like the new Mariner card that Spirits is playing, as well as mainboard Stony Silence on a Body, the new Green Oof, again, all new cards from the supposed Commander set, those cards, those were hosing us, that the Oof turns off our altar, and the new Mariner means we can't actually kill our opponent by comboing them, we have to kill them with traditional combat. Iconic Wound allows us to just kill a few enemy creatures game one. Well, I also found that when we're sideboarding into the wound against those decks, we will also counterplay Graveyard Hate. So we're sideboarding into more graveyard-reliant cards, which is not how you beat Graveyard Hate. So I think Necrotic Wound is correct in the main board. In our sideboard, we have ways to deal with hate. Now, the deck can be quite resilient against hate anyway, because that's quite a good value plan. But we have three Wismere and a Godless Shrine to sideboard into against enchantments like Leon of the Void and Rest in Peace. The reason we're playing Wismere over a disenchant effect of a similar type is that Wismere is only one mana to evoke, so it's a one mana demystifier. Essentially, but it also triggers Bridge from Below in our graveyard if we have a Bridge from Below in our graveyard, if we're blowing up a non-rip, for example. It also allows us to put something into our graveyard that we can delve, but any other spell would do that. So it's mainly the Bridge from Below interaction, essentially. So that's the Wismere there. We then have Ingot Chewer, which is the same thing but for artifacts. Again, it's one mana. And again, these both get through Chance of the Void on one and Chance of the Void on two as well, which our other hate does not. We have one copy of Shenanigans, which gets around Chance of the Void on one. Chance of the Void is actually quite a good way to combat this deck. So having hate for Chance of the Void is quite important, but it also kills Grafdiggers, Cages, and similar. So that's in our sideboard as well. It's got Dredge. It's the only Dredge card in our Dredge-style deck. Then we have four Leyland of the Void. This is for things like the Mirror, Dredge, and also, don't forget that Emrakul kind of hoses our primary combo plan. We can still beat a main board at Emrakul, but it's a consideration to get the Emrakul decks. We then have Crypt Breaker, which is a card that has seen play in Legacy Reanimator as a way of beating hate. Essentially, it allows us to discard cards in our hand to make 2-2 zombies and tap zombies to draw cards. Now, if we've started to go off and got a few zombies in play from the bridge from below, or any of our zombie creatures, which is our 4 Stitchers, 4 Grave Crawlers, 4 Carrion Feeders, this becomes a good way to draw cards and outvalue our opponent. And then finally, we've got ways to fight Surgical Extraction. Silent Gravestones allow us to fight Surgical Extraction, and also Exile Graveyards in the Mirror again. That is the deck. I've played a little bit with it. We had a 4-1 on stream, I think it was. The deck seems incredibly powerful. I hope you enjoy the video. Leave me a comment below. Let me know what you think we could do to refine the lists. Not as much use buying into the deck, as I'm sure something will be banned from it. Maybe it's time for Bridge from Below to bite the dust, or maybe Faithless Looting is just too good at enabling decks like this. Don't forget, this video is brought to you and hosted by ChannelFireball.com, your premier source for news, entertainment, and strategy around Magic the Gathering. We've also got a great shop for singles and sealed product as well. I'm Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/PleasantKenobi. We play a lot of Modern, Legacy, Commander, and a little bit of Standard here and there. I play a lot of Magic and talk about Magic, and I just love Magic. If you're looking for a pro to show you how to be pro, I'm not your boy. I'm just your friendly, bearded, neighbourhood British lad. With all that out of the way, let's play some Magic. We have won the die roll in round one. Oh, no, we haven't. I'm lying. We've lost the die roll in round one. This deck often keeps one landers. I think we keep this. We want a looting turn one to find our second land, put Bridge from Below in the bin, and go from there. We're against Holy Diver, a known streamer, a very good Magic player. I like to play crazy Is It decks, and most likely if they beat our obnoxious graveyard-based deck, they will tweet about it with an image, I've noticed. So I look forward to that, said no one ever. Right, let's go ahead and loot Faithlessly. We found a Bloodgust and a Hogaak, so I guess I'm going to ditch the Bloodgust and the Bridge from Below and pass the turn. Next turn we'll get to get back our Bloodgust, and we're going to play Carrion Feeder and another body, and that will allow us to start doing our Bridge stuff. Now, if they are playing some form of Drakes, Phoenixes, sorry, which I think is what Hodover has been playing a lot of, we might be in for a main board Surgical. Thing in the Ice is also pretty good against us. Kiln Fiend. Okay. That's also pretty good against us, to be fair, as it's going to hit us for a lot of damage. But we should have a lot of blockers, to be honest. So we're going to go, Bloodstained Mire. Get back our Bloodgust. Say yes to that ability. Then, I want a Carrion Feeder online so we can get Bridge from Lows back. The question is whether we play another Stitcher Supply or whether we play an Instant Neonate. That's the real question. Instant Neonate does let us draw one deeper, put our Hogaak in the bin. We do need to dig for our altar now, so Neonate allows us to do that. So I think I play the Neonate. We're also going to crack this fetch here. We're going to go get one of our Blood Crypts untapped and play the Carrion Feeder as well, because this gives us a sack outlift our Bloodgust. This way we've got quite a few blockers for this Kiln Fiend, and then we're not attacking. We're just gonna be on blocks for a little bit. I'm assuming with a Kiln Fiend deck as well, there's definitely gonna be main board Surgicals, because that's a card that easily helps you to get your Storm count up, or in this case, pseudo front-end fire-breathing prowess, or whatever you describe it as. I wonder if they play Distortion Strike in the Kiln Fiend deck. That would be pretty bad for us, as we don't really have any removal main board or in the deck. Really, we have two copies of Necrotic Wound, and that's it. So, they've played their third land. I really don't know what the Kiln Fiend decks even play anymore. I don't even know if it's a prominent thing. Okay. I'm assuming we'll see an attack here of some description. I guess Temur Battle Rage is a thing, right? So we need to be careful not to get randomly blown up by that. Let's discard our Hogaak to our Neonate. And make a Bridge trigger. What did we draw? A Zombo into play and a Blood Cup into hand. Before we get a blocks, do I suck my Bloodghast? I definitely do. And I guess there's a small chance they have mutagenic growths and all sorts of nonsense to kill us here. But I'm just going to block with a 2-2. Maybe it's safer to block with 2-2-2s. But in some ways I want them to pump their Kill and Fiend to keep it alive so that we don't end up losing our Bridge from Below in the bin. So they're bottling our face and they're disrupting, shoaling their own bolt. Interesting. Timber Battle Rage. Okay, this is going to get very big. So that's a 10, bought our face, 14, take 20. That's a pretty good turn 3 kill. I'm not going to lie. And the double strike. There we go. We're dead on turn 3 to Lightning Bolt, Disrupting Shoal, Temur Battle Rage. What was X2? What did they exile? Thing in the ice. Interesting. So if we had blocked with both zombies, we still would be dead. So there's not really much we could do there against that kill. What do we need to beat that? Well, nothing in our deck really does anything against that. We can bring the Silent Gravestones in case of Surgicals, I guess. They're kind of dead cards otherwise, though. But I'm assuming there will be Surgicals in somewhere in the 75. So we're going to bring our surgical anti-surgical attack. We're going to bring in... Do we want Crypt Breakers here? Probably not. We want Crypt Breakers more against like white and black decks for the Ley Line and the Rip matchups. I'm going to trim a Bloodghast, two Bloodghasts I can't block, because we might need quite a few blockers here. I guess I should have just delved for a Hogaak to block with. That might have been correct last turn, last game. I wasn't sure what was in our bin. I can't remember. Would you like to play first? Yes, I would. And we can ditch Avenge Vine on turn 1, and then we can alter ourselves. Doesn't seem that great, if I'm honest. This hand doesn't seem very good. It's got anti-surgical hay, it's got a 1 drop, it's got an alter, but I don't think we have time to set up. I think we have to be really fast or just die. I'm going to mulligan this. The double Venge Vine, not only one way to ditch them. Okay, this is fine. Let's keep this. We have a lot of ways that can't, things that can't block, which is kind of funny. Okay, we need something to ditch the Bridge from Below. That's what we need. Let's go shock ourselves, play a Grave Crawler. Yeah. Well, I wasn't confident against Holy Diver's nonsense. But now I'm even less confident after the turn 3 kill, because that was pretty solid. I don't know if that's a nut hand. That's got to be a nut hand, right? Or is this just where Modern is at now? Because Stoneforge Mystic would just be too absurd, wouldn't it? Absolutely too absurd. Right, let's untap and draw a Faith that's looting. That's pretty good here. Let's go and get a carrion. A swamp for our carrion feeder. I think I played Silent Gravestone before I loot this bridge into the bin just because of surgicals. If they have a surgical now, they might just go and get the Verdant Catacombs with it. Cool. So we're surgical proof for a turn. That's nice, I guess. Then every turn we can make two zombies by sacking our Grave Caller and replaying out of the bin with our carrion feeder. That's not too bad. We get a counter and make a zombie with Bridge from Below in the bin. So ideally with our Faith is Looting, we want to find like a second bridge and a land. That would be the best possible draws, I think. Thing in the Ice is very good against us. Very, very good against us. Yeah, maybe Thing in the Ice is the best way to fight the Hogaak deck. That's the thing, this deck, the cat is out of the bag. Everyone is playing this stuff now. So playing against... So my first game with this deck, actually, 2 or 3 days ago, I played against a main board Rest in Peace in game 1. Just stuff like that. But Thing in the Ice is actually a legitimate card that isn't just sideboard hate. That is main deckable, that is very good against us just building a board state. I guess we've got like a turn, perhaps, to draw into our combo, which would be pretty good. Okay, there was a long pause there. I'm not sure what that was for. Perhaps talking to stream. And we're gonna... Yes, we're gonna untap. Get a Black Cleave Cliffs, which isn't terrible. I'm gonna faithlessly loot. What do we find with our looting? Ultra of Dementia and Hogaak. Those are pretty good finds, I'm not gonna lie. So we're gonna go to combat and swing. Guess we're getting for two, three here. Wow, they blocked the two, what? Attack with the feeder. We can go with the feeder first and attack with it, then we definitely get through. That's probably better. Or we can try and go for a kill. Is trying to go for a kill better? Or do we set up for next turn? Because we can play the altar here, sack our Gravecaller to mill ourselves for two, and make a Zombo. At that point, we can then sack our Carrion Feeder to make a Zombo to mill ourselves as well. And then we've got a hope. Because if we get second bridge into the bin, we're kind of golden. That's much better against the thing in the ice, I guess. Let's try it. We also want to cast Ultra Dementia when they're tapped out. But they are playing Disrupting Shoals. They could just like pitch a thing in the ice here and count our Ultra Dementia. And that would be pretty bad for us. Yeah. There we go. Disrupting Shoal, pitching Disrupting Shoal. Good way to beat the early combo decks, right? So that is frustrating, but not terrible. I guess there's an argument that we could have not played the altar because then we're playing around it, but then getting our Gravecaller counted? Eh, I'm unsure. Block the Gravecrawler, sure. And then we just go and make some extra damage here. And we just hope to God they can't cast three spells next turn. And then hopefully... Maybe casting Hogaak was just correct anyway because it kills them faster. Oh God. Oh God. Ooh, Prismatic Vista. So they're playing four Tarn for that, I guess. Mutagenic Growth. Oh God. Well, that's a flip thing in the ice. That's now a 9-18 damage. Those are some godlike hands. Or is the deck really that consistent off just sleight of hand and Serum Visions? That's a 9-10. That's 18 damage. We are dead. We are very, very dead. On turn 3 again, I hasten to add. So welcome to Modern, where everyone's goldfishing as hard as they can. Except one of these goldfish decks is playing Disrupting Shoal, which is ironic, really, that we just had Force Negation and Disrupting Shoal evidently is better. Although Disrupting Shoal would have done the same thing. Yeah, well played. I enjoyed that. Okay, we've won the die roll. We've got a one lander with Insolent Neonate and a Faithless Looting and a Bridge and a Vengevine and a Hogaak. All we're missing is a Sack Outlet. I can't not keep this, really. I'm going to turn one Faithless Looting to try and set up Gravecaller and Neonate on turn two. This way we've got Vengevine in the bin, the bridge from below, and we should get a lot of gas out of that. So, hopefully this goes better than our first round did. Let's get a Blood Crypt tap, say yes, and then we're going to play a red and cast Faithless Looting. Here we go. We found Looting in the Cliffs, so we're going to ditch Vengevine and Bridge from below. Wonder what absurd... Turn 3 kill deck we're going to face in Modern in this round. Wooded Foothills, okay, good, good. Is this into Blood Crypt, into Faithless Looting, into Ditching Vengevine Bridge from below? That'd be pretty funny. What you got for me, my friend? Stomping Grounds, interesting. Not a land you see very often, Modern. Scapeshift or... Oh, it's Burn. Nothing too exciting. Or some form of Burn with the green in it, okay. So Burn seems like it could be fast enough to beat us, but I think we've got a good start with the way our hand is looking. Okay, cool. So we can go Black Cleave Cliffs, Insolent Neonate. Do I sack my Neonate to try and draw? No. Gravecrawler. Trigger my Vengevine. Say yes to my Vengevine. Make a Vengevine. Go to combat and attack with it. And it goes. Where will it stop? Nobody knows. And then if I discard Hogaak to instant Neonate, I'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We won't be able to make a Neonate. And we'll be one shot. We're too short if we want to keep our bridge from below around as well. I think at this point I'm happy to sack my Neonate to ditch my Bloodstained Mire to make a 2-2 to block that Monastery Swiss Spear. Sacred Foundry. Second Swift Spear. Third Swift Spear. Woof! That's a hasty hand, shall we say. No attacks. Okay, they want blockers, which is more than fair enough. What do we draw? Bridge from Below is a very good draw here. I'm gonna crack this Bloodstained Mire. Could get a swamp. Cast this Faithless Looting out of our graveyard. Find a Vengevine. And a Bridge from Below. Interesting, interesting. I guess we're ditching the Bridge from Below in the Vengevine, right? There's just no two ways about it. The thing is, they're going to block with some creatures. We're going to lose our bridges this turn. So I think what I'll probably do is ditch my Vengevine, ditch my bridge, sacrifice this, discarding the Bloodstained Mire, trigger my bridge a couple times, make some zombos, draw the Carrion Feeder. Oh! If we'd drawn Carrion Feeder in our Faithless Looting, we could now ditch our grave. We cast our mana on our Faithless Looting. It means we can cast our Gravecrawler multiple times next turn for multiple Vengevines, though. We're then going to cast this. Ditching Bloodstained Mire, Bloodstained Mire, Bloodstained Mire, Instant Neonate. Oof. I guess one of our bridges. The bridges are useless now if they block, right? Then we're going to combat attack. If they don't block, we're in a good spot. If they do block, which they kind of have to, then we lose a bridge. Yeah, some blocks. They lose a Military Swiss Spear, but they take 2 and get an 8. We lose our bridge out of the graveyard. That's a pretty good turn 3, if I'm not going to lie. It's not quite a kill, but it's pretty good regardless. Next turn, we'll play Carrion Feeder, sack our Vengevine, sack our Gravecrawler. We play Gravecrawler twice, bring both the Vengevines back, and then swing for a huge amount of damage. That might be a little bit of overkill, actually, looking at the board state. I have lost a burn playing this deck. Eidolon can be actually quite a pain if played on turn 2 on the play, and we haven't set up our board yet, because a lot of our deck is just one drops, if you look at the list. Also, rip out of the board can be a problem too, and they can just be really fast. Really, really fast. So we want Wismaz for Rest in Peace and for Eidolon. We're going to drop a Blood Crypt for our God of the Shrine and 3 Blood Gusts, I guess? Yeah. Necrotic Rune doesn't seem too hot, actually. Maybe we drop that as well instead. Yeah, we'll drop that instead. Let's go with that. We have Wismaz literally for Eidolon and for Rip. If they happen to have Relic and or Cage, well, maybe you should trim card a Bloodgast for that, but for the shenanigans and the Ingot Chewers, but I'm not sure. On the upside, Ingot Chewer doesn't trigger Eidolon, so that's nice. Not that it deals with it, obviously. Oh god, blimey. Played a lot of magic today. It's tiring work, he says. It's awesome work. I could not love doing this job any more than I already do. Just waiting on our opponent here. Bloodghast, Wispman, Hogaak, and Faithless Looming. I think this is fine. It's nowhere near as explosive as our previous hand, but it doesn't die to Graveyard Hate, which is one of the upsides. Which means the links are looting on turn one quite awkward, because I kind of want to see if they rip us so we can Wispman it. So I might not looting on turn one. It sounds like a very weird place to be. I'm just going to pollute Delta Pass. What an account. This is like zoo. That's a blast from the past, some might say. Okay, I generally just thought it was burn with... Well, I know burn doesn't really play green anymore, but I just assumed it was like an old burn build with Tarkus commands and stuff. Let's not pay two and just pass the turn. Okay. Let's see if we see a rip from them turn two. If not, I can go looting into Bloodghast next turn. It slows down the clock like zero, really. Also gives another draw step to see more cards off our looting. Okay, we're getting two'd. They didn't play a second land. Are they missing land drops? Oh, they are. Shimmerhand can't punish that right now. What else do we draw? An Altar of Dementia, eh? That ain't too bad. Let's cast Faithless Living. Find another Wispman, another Altar of Dementia. Let's get rid of Bloodghast and Hogaak, because they don't seem too hot in our hand. Let's play a Verdant Catacombs to get back our Bloodghast that can't block. Then we're going to get a God of Shrine end step, and then guess we're kind of off to the races? Kinda? That's a Swift Spear. Okay, we're going to take five here. Okay, their one lander's doing pretty well because we're just spinning our wheels over here. With two sideboard cards that might not even be relevant. I mean, we can fetch into Swamp to double mill ourselves here. Doesn't seem awful. Nene also seems pretty good. I guess I'm going to go to combat anyway. They go to 15. Well, they're going to sacrifice our Bloodghast and mill ourselves. Let's see what we find. Did we hit a bridge from below? We did hit a bridge from below. That's pretty good. So I'm going to play Bloodstained Mire. Always yes to this. So yes. I'm going to tongue ourselves again with a Bloodghast sacking. Okay. Get a Zombo. Okay. That's us for two more. Hit a Gravecrawler and a Bloodghast. No, the Bloodghast is our one. We haven't got another Bloodghast. Crack this. Get a Blood Crypt. Say yes. Use Bloodghast ability. I will indeed use Bloodghast ability. Sacrifice this to mill ourselves again. Okay. Hit another. Did we hit? No, we did not hit. So we're going to play Instant Neonate. And then we're going to discard a card to draw a card. Do we want to mill ourselves for one? What's better here? Because we just discard the altar, right? Get another Zombo. Do we want another altar? Okay. Then we're going to cast Hogaak. So this is the first time we've got to see the power so far. So Hogaak, ditching anything we don't want. So Stitcher, land, altar. Cool. We're then going to sacrifice it to mill ourselves. Which gets us a Zombo. And hopefully hits another bridge, because then we're off to the races. Oh, we didn't hit another bridge. That's really frustrating. I mean, if we tap out and don't get there, we probably die. I'm going to do it. Let's exile. I think there's some tricks you can do with like exiling Hogaaks, but I don't want to. Because I'll probably mess it up. We've already got looting in the bin there, so just do that. And then we're going to go sack this, target ourselves again, sacking the Hogaak, getting a Zombo. We'll always yield to this. And did we hit another bridge? Sweet. But we did not. But we cannot cast another creature. Okay, we've got to survive for a turn. And then we can hopefully kill them. If we hit a bridge on our second mill, we would have gone infinite there. I think, did I mess up? Could I have tapped my existing Hogaak for the last Hogaak? Is that how that works? I don't think it does. Maybe I'm wrong there, I'm not sure. So attack all the creatures. We're going to windmill block one of these Nicatals. Sure, I'm going to take two and get a six. Oh, I'm an idiot. Why did I do that? Just lost both our bridges. Derp. Oh, you can tell I don't play Georgia very often, can't you? That was bad. That was really bad. I should not have done that. That was about as bad as it could be. Okay, let's say yes to this. Yes to this. Let's cast a Hogaak. Oh, God, that was bad, Vince. That was so bad. Okay. Well, that was a punt, some might say. Let's go ahead and get rid of everything we don't need. So, Insolent Neonate, Verdant Catacombs, Blood Crypt, Blackcleave Cliffs, and then one of these guys? Sure. And we're going to mill ourselves a bunch to try and find our other two bridges. Oh, Gordon Bennett. We could probably win through combat damage, but I don't want to win through combat damage. Combat damage is lame. Let's go ahead and sacrifice... Targeting ourselves, sacking this Bloodghast first. Bridge one, sacrifice, target ourselves, this Bloodghast. Okay, right, okay, we're back online with another bridge. Can I fumble it anymore? And then we're going to go sacrifice, target ourselves with this one. So we hit another bridge, okay. I think we're now live to kill them. Now I've fumbled it about as hard as I possibly can. Do we have a swamp in our graveyard? Do we have a swamp in our exile zone? So I'm going to fetch one and get our grave callers back. Oh, you know what? It's just quicker to look. No, we don't. Cool. Yes, I would like to use all those abilities. Yes. 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 Okay. Let's play a Hogaak. Oh god, I made life really hard for myself a moment ago, didn't I, by losing my bridges. That was a tweet moment. Yeah, this Altered Dimension can go. Trigger these. Always yield. Always yes. Of course I do. Okay. Then we're going to go sack, target them with this one. Sack, target them with this one. Sack, target them with... Whoops. Sack, target them with this one. And then 45. So I need to probably... Sack, target them with this one. It's number 8. Then we're going to cast another one. Tap in these. I'm going to go Whismere, Neonate, Hogaak, Carrion Feeder, sure. I'm going to sack this one, and then we got it. I think we got it. Save targets, same targets each time. Let's sack this one for 8. This one for another 2. This one for another 2. Let's scoop it up. Do they scoop it up? I think they scoop it up. Okay, we got there. So, that's the deck actually doing what it's meant to do and not just folding on turn 3 or 4 to a combo deck. Our opponent got very unlucky. Very, very unlucky and very screwed in game 2. So that's unfortunate for them. Especially when our start was quite slow. We only killed in turn 4. And this is modern. This is not a turn 4 format as much as Wizards would like to pretend it is. On to the next round. Okay, we've won the die roll against Noerd. I thought I said no red for a moment. Our hand is Faithless, Hogaak, Altar, Carrion, two lands, a Stitcher. I think this sounds pretty gas. I'm going to keep this. Between Faithless Looting Stitcher and the Altar, sacking the Stitcher, I think we can easily find a bridge from below into our yard. And then we're off to the races. Maybe. Hopefully. Yes. If Stitcher hits a... Well, the question is, do I go Stitcher turn one? That's the thing. I think I do. No, I go Faithless. Then I got two one drops for the Vengevine on turn 2. Let's take a look at what we find. Is it a Vengevine? Our opponent's thinking about this. They've got to figure if they forced it. Force negation. Okay, let's drop an Alter Dementia and a Hogaak into our bin. No surprises for what we're playing here. Imagine if they surgical my Alter now. That's the world we live in. That's the world we live in. Are you happy to raise your children in that world? Turn 3 kills. Andrassi Temple. Okay. Interesting, interesting, interesting. What do we draw? A Carrion Feeder. Okay. Let's go. I want this Alter Dementia out of my hand in case they thought not searing me. The others are all kind of expendable. Well, Stitcher Supply is very, very good. But, yeah, I want that out of hand. So we're going to go like that, and then we're going to go bop, bop. Next turn, we're going to make a Hogaak, most likely. And go from there. If they're black-white Ardwazi, then we need to be aware of, like, a Path to Exile and such. I hope this isn't a Thorn Seer, because Stitcher Supply is so unbelievably good next turn. One time no TKS? I mean, why would they keep that hand? Unless the Exile Sin Spirit got a Reality Smash. So that's probably worse. Chalice on 1. Well, that is really bad for us here. The irony being that I thought the temple meant TKS. Oh, I was wrong. Okay. Okay, what can we do? What can we do? Nothing. We've got no options here. We just want Blood Ghasts, basically. Or discard Vengevines to hand size. That's another option. I know that doesn't sound very good. That's because it isn't very good. Oh, it's Eldrazi Tron. How boring. How pedestrian. Is this a TKS now? Well, doesn't really matter here, does it? Let's be honest. So Chance on 1 is a very easy way to beat this deck, I think. I mean, you tell me how you feel about that. Do you think Chance of the Void decks are... Decks you want to play with. Let's go Polluted Delta and pass the turn. Can't cast the Looting in the Bin because it costs 3. They played very well there. They've played the Thought Shards after we played the Altar, where they probably would have played the other way around if we'd... Okay, that's a Reality Smasher. I'm going to just go fill up my deck now for 1 card. We very much need to draw Blood Ghasts and only Blood Ghasts to be able to sack them to put them in a bin with an Ultra Dementia and then draw nothing but lands after that and then to hit like multiple bridges off of it and just really get lucky, basically. Actually, no, we don't even have the chance now. We're just going to die next turn. We had a turn where we had to. Okay. So the Chalice of the Void absolutely murdered us, which is great. I'm really glad everyone's playing those. I can bet some of the people 5-0 in this deck just dodge the challenge decks every single time. Because Magic is a skill game. Magic is a skill game. I kind of want to bring my Crypt Breakers in. But they're 1-drops. And also, I don't think we're getting... They might Leyline us, I guess. Necrotic Wounds seems bad into the challenge deck, doesn't it? Okay, let's cut another 1-drop. Let's cut Carrion. No, let's cut Gravecrawler. No, let's cut Neonate. The zombie synergies are too strong. Too darn strong. Okay, we need a faster hand this time. And we need to not die to one chalice. That was a weird sentence. Chalice on one. I'd like to play first. Yes, I would. We've got shenanigans. I'm going to keep this. We want to ditch these two and find lands of our faithless. There's a chance we never see a second land and the game is over, but you know. That's magic, right? That's magic. That's magic, you know. Can't believe it's not so. Okay, we're going to put Bridge from Below and Venge around our graveyard. And then we're going to draw a second land next turn. Right, magic? Are they going to go Charles on one off of Simeon? No, this can go Expedition Map. Okay. So they might just Tron us on turn three here. Hopefully we create another board presence that doesn't matter. That'd be nice. Land? Yeah, it's not a land. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. So, let's go. Gravecrawler. And pass the turn. Oh, I wish it was a land. God, I've never wanted Old Dimension to be a land so much in my life. Just want to get lucky, you know? It's better to be lucky than good. It's better to be lucky than good. Paying costs. Surgical. Okay. Well, means we can still Vengevine the next turn. But our bridges are gone. God, the graveyard hate is real, isn't it? I think I missed the boat on playing this for CFB. I had very good runs with it in my other content. And then I play it for CFB and everyone's just like, oh, I'm just gonna get you. I played some practice rounds, not practice rounds, some recorded rounds on my channel and got pretty hard for surgicals, actually. So. Yes. I see. I see what you did there. We're going to draw a land and we're going to shenanigans that map. I can search, right? Yeah, I can search. Just expecting. I'm going to search as well. We're getting rid of the maps, they don't just Tron us, I guess. And then next turn, we're going to get rid of the Chalice, and the turn after, we're going to make a Vengevine. So if we got rid of the Chalice here, and then they Tron us, I guess they'd only have 3 mana. Could they pay for 3 mana? A Trinisphere? Who plays Staxi Prison decks? Oh, well, that was a bad shenanigans, wasn't it? Because they just had it anyway. Gordon Bennett. Man. Okay, no TKSs, no Reality Smashes, no Ugins or Khan. So I guess we've dodged a bullet. I think it's safe to say. Okay. Crack the Rhinestone searching for one of those things. Can we just fade it? Can we just dodge it for once? Like. So let's get that back. Let's blow up this. And then next turn, we'll have the turn. The turn. I mean, attacking with our Gravecrawler there might have been the correct thing to do. Okay, that takes. Well, anything it wants, really. I guess you'd take the Hogaak, because I can cast it next turn. The Hogaak seems like a good take. Carrion Feeder also kind of stops the Hogaak, but I can draw a lot of one drops, where drawing another Hogaak is quite difficult. I personally hope they don't take the Hogaak. That's how I... They took the Hogaak. Okay. Should have sworn my Gravecrawler, really. Hoping they'd block. Chalice on 2. That's my Altar of Dementia. Okay, and the shenanigans in my graveyard. Nice, 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 nice. Okay, sure, 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 sure. Draw another one drop then? Is that where we want to be at now? I think it is. No. That is not another one drop. Okay. Let's cast this looting. Do we want to? No. No, we don't. Okay. Put those in the graveyard. Gravecrawler's getting in. They don't block, which is clever, because that gives us two one drops to get our Vengevine back. So that was the correct thing to do. We're just on the whole hope they don't have anything planned again, which isn't the best place to be. It's a map. Okay. That's certainly not something. What utility lands could they have that are any good? Blast Zone, perhaps? Yep, there it is. Seems strong. I think 7 here. Jeez. It's brutalizing us here. Blast Zone, okay. Well, Blast Zone can kill our Carrion Feeder as well, which means we don't have very good blocks there. Cancel that, no. Draw a Vengevine, that's not what we wanted to draw. God damn it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Bring back our Bloodghast. Play a Carrion Feeder. Wow, they can get me here, can't they? This trick on the stack, they can Blast Zone me so I can't play it and can't get the Vengevine. No, they're going to let me. Okay, cool. Vengevine can block that Thought Knot here then. Yes, I would like to use that ability. Okay. Guess just do it again. Yes. Okay. We have bodies. Three of them can't block, but we have bodies. Two of them die to Chalice of the... Not Chalice of the... Blast Zone. But we have bodies. They have one card in hand. Do they blow the Blast Zone now? Guess they can blow it whenever they want to. Like a Neonate into... So drawing Neonate, discarding the Vengevine, then playing a Hogaak would be pretty gas. And I think it's probably our only way of really getting back in this. We are dead to a Smasher. We're also dead to a Khan. We're dead to an Ugin. We're dead to, like, basically just Tron things. Just any Tron things, really. They can't attack if they don't have a way to kill me, because I'll just Vengevine, block the Thornton Seal, and draw a card. But then they take me to 2... Okay, they didn't do it. Interesting. No mill. Okay. Let's attack with all this stuff then. I can attack with a Vengevine and then reset it with a Carrion Feeder on my hand if they don't realize the Blast Zone interaction. So I guess I do that. Yeah, I do that. They can Blast Zone here, they can block the Vengevine and the... They can let the Vengevine through, to be fair. They can let it all through, to be fair, but they shouldn't probably do that. So after damage, I'm going to sack that Bloodghast to my Carrion Feeder. Okay, we're then going to sack this Vengevine to this. Then I'm going to sack this Carrion Feeder to this. And hopefully this tricks them into, like, blowing their load, as it were. Play Gravecrawler. Sack the Gravecrawler. Play the Gravecrawler again. Get my Vengevine back. Okay, they've let me do it again. So that's nice. Keep the Carrion Feeder in my hand for when I need it. Which will be next turn, probably, because they're going to use the Blast Zone to kill out my 1-1s. I didn't play a land for my Bloodghast for some reason. I guess not doing so means I can trick them and haste out a Bloodghast that they're not aware of. So there is that. I'm dead to any removal spell that can kill this Vengevine, as I said before. Even, like, a Spatial Contortion would get it there. Which would be pretty brutal. On the upside, I can sack it for value to the Carrion Feeder, so I die with an 8-8 in play if they do kill it. Okay, is this just a really big walking ballista? All is dust. Well, then I'm just dead. Why did they think about that for so long? Yep, seems strong. All is dust is a good magic card. On to the next round. Yeah, on to the next round. We have lost the die roll, but we have a hand with, like, Vengevine Stitcher. So I can't keep this. If we had a Faithless Looming in our hand, I probably would keep this. I guess I'd consider keeping this, but I can't keep this. This hand is garbage. This hand is a two lander with two lootings, an altar, and a Vengevine. I'm going to keep this and try and set up two one drops in turn two if I can. We're going to bottom that. We lost the die roll, so we're on the draw. Oh, it's some form of affinity, perhaps. Could be worse. No, it's just hardened skills of affinity. Say just. That deck seems to have a good matchup against this because you can sack all your dudes just to pop up bridges. So now I've got to play my bridges in a more smart and more efficient way. Okay, let's go Blood Crypt, pay my life, play a Faithless Looting, draw two cards. What do we find? What do we find? Looting in a swamp. Let's put Bridge and Vengevine up in. Guess we cast quite a lot of Faithless Lootings over the first couple of turns. Then hopefully go off. Maybe, hopefully. That Tron game felt close to the second one. They were quite low. It wasn't as close if they just popped their Blast Zoners once the first Carrion Feeder sack. Ancient Stirrings, what are we going to find? Which is stronger, Faithless Little or Ancient Stirrings? Ancient Stirrings found as a hangerback. I wonder if that's what they wanted to find there, because our looting didn't find what I wanted to find, that's for sure. Guess you never have to really worry about banning looting if it's just terrible. They just played a hangerback for zero to kill our bridge. That's fine, it's a one for one. Well, actually, it's not even a one for one. I didn't spend any mana on, or any part of my turn on the bridge mine. It's a discard to Faithless Looting. Guess they spent no mana as well, in all fairness. Okay, let's go and draw a card. Draw another bridge. Sure, that's pretty strong. That's pretty strong. That's Faithless Loot. Ditch a bridge and a grave crawler. Crack this. And get myself a blood crypt and shock myself, which is kind of painful, but whatever. I'm going to pay a neonate. I'm going to sack it later in case I draw something to it. I want to sack like another bridge or a Vengevine. I could sack it in their end step and make a grave call in their turn. Depends. Depends what they play now. If they play an Outbound, I'll draw similar. Yeah, I probably just sack this now then. So we get at least one zombie out of this. Having the zombie means the grave call in our bin isn't useless as well. It means we can get Vengevine back if we draw a sack outlet too. Oh, we have a sack outlet in our hand. What about we draw a land to be able to do that? Graft, no, apparently they don't want to do that, I'd imagine. No. We draw a Blood Crypt, it's pretty good. No, we can't go Gravecrawler into sack this turn. So what do we draw? Bloodstained Mire. So I'm going to loot. Find Bloodghast and Carrion Feeder. Let's discard this and discard this. Play this. Shock myself. Bring back the Blood Ghast, which is cool. God, I hate Lenoir Reborn so much. Just this whole triggering every time. Play a Carrion Feeder. Always yield. And then we're going to play the Grave Call out of our bin, which then gets us a Vengevine. Not bad for a turn three. Not bad. Then we just attack. If they block with our Outbound Ravager, we lose a bridge. But I mean, look at our board state. Oh, they've conceded to that. Okay. That was a pretty strong turn three. They only have one card left in hand, I guess. Even if they destroy the bridge, they still got a Vengevine and a Carrion Feeder to deal with. Their affinity, so two ingot chewers and shenanigans, seems pretty strong against them. I'm going to bring in four ley lines, I think, because between Artbound Ravager, Walking Ballista, and Hangerback Walker, they have too many effects that go to the graveyard and get rid of our bridges. It also just turns off the modular ability of the Artbound Ravager, and it turns off the modular ability if they're playing the new construct tutor creature from whatever it's called, from the new set, from Modern Horizons. Let's get rid of these necrotic wounds. Let's trim a Bloodghast and a Neonate. Maybe two Bloodghasts and two Neonates? No. Guess trimming a bridge might be the correct thing to do, but making a Hogaak's pretty good because they will struggle to kill it with the Walking Ballista. Two Neonates, two Bloodghasts, a bridge from below, and two Necrotic Wounds. I don't know if that's correct. Neonate seems very good at like enabling the deck, but at the same time, if trimming a bridge is ever correct. We'll see. Leyline, I've got Stitcher plus Faithless. Yeah, seems pretty good. Let's keep this. Put onto the battlefield. Say okay. So they're green, right? So the natural state is probably the normal. Graft Digger's Cage. Nice. Guess we aren't Vengevining until we get an ingot thingy. Ingot guy? Ingot dude? Whatever it's called. Right. Let's go and try and find one. Shenanigans. No, that was not shenanigans. Let's play Faithless Looting. We found Altar and we found Vengevine. Okay. Sorry, no, Altar and Black Cliffs. But I'm ditching Vengevine. I'm ditching Bloodghast. And then next turn I'm going to go Looting. In case I find the Ingot Chewer. What we also want to do off the looting is find a third land, so we're just looting again to try and find an Ingot Chewer. Inkmoth Nexus, that's a scary magic card. Artbound Ravager, okay. Well, at least I can't modular onto it right now. Right. What do we draw? Hogaak, the Arisen Necropolis. Okay, we can actually cast that from hand, so that's quite nice. Okay, I'm going to say yes, and then... Oh, it doesn't exile, does it? Okay, cool, it doesn't. Sweet. Blood Crypt and Neonate. So we're going to ditch... Oh, this is tough. This is tough. The Hogaak might just be a legitimate threat. But we need two black creatures in play to play the Hogaak. So I guess we ditch the Neonate and the... Altar, maybe? No, the Altar's too good. The Altar's too good. Oh, the tension. Because three lands allows us to Faithlessly loot again. But... I need the two black creatures. I need the Altar. Because the Altar can go find me bridges that I can sack stuff to make zombos. I think I'm actually... Because I can also mill the shenanigans and then play it, so... Yeah, let's play the Stitcher and try and find the shenanigans. God, I hate the word shenanigans. It's kind of a word that some quirky guy in like a fedora that comes to parties that you don't really enjoy interacting with would say, you know? I'm going to regret not getting that third land, aren't I? I can see it now. We can play Hogaak next turn, and that is definitely something. Are they just going to ink moth us for one? For two? Oh, okay. That is a clock, I guess. Sure. Two infect. Not good. We don't have any instant speed ways to kill that either. Ley line. Let's go carrion feeder. Let's cast a Hogaak with black, black, Verdant, Blood Crypt, Blood Crypt, Neonate, Stitcher Supplier. We would have a damn cage. Damn you, cage! Okay. That's in play, which is good. Next time we're going to play Ultra Dementia and then start milling ourselves to try and find shenanigans. He says, tipping his fedora. Balding Jar. Well, that's a pain. Ancient Stirrings. Hopefully not for anything good. Like, just grab a forest. Yeah, Darksteel Citadel. Well, actually, Darksteel Citadel was like 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 4 artifacts to go on the Inkmoth Nexus, so they can kill us, like, in a turn's time. Okay, that's a 2, 3. Next turn, it's a 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Whew. 3 turn clock. Okay, what's next? Can we draw some gas? We drew another Hogaak. Not the worst, but not also not really the best. Let's play this altar. Attack with all our stuff. Okay, we get him here. For 10. So that's pretty good. And then we're gonna go sack this. We did not mill the shenanigans. Oh god. Oh god. We're gonna die! We're gonna die! But the thing is, even shenanigans is now not really worth it. It doesn't do anything, like, other than us perhaps kill them, combo kill them. Because I think they just kill us with infect, right? They attack us for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, we're dead here. If they go for it, we're dead. Bloody infect. It's so unfair, says the guy playing the Hogaak, like, Vengevine deck. That's a second cage. Hopefully they just don't go for it. They miss it. And then we have a turn of doing stuff? Question mark. We are very dead here if they just sack all their artifacts onto it. Okay, we have a turn to draw Ingotura or Shenanigans, because if we target this, they'll regenerate it, which taps it, and then we get to kill them. So that's literally our out here. That's not it. Okay. No. Okay. No. They don't have any mana to put counters on. They don't have any mana to put counters on this. So if we just... Oh, they can regenerate it for after combat. Derp, 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 derp. Okay. Attack with everything. Oh, they blocked in a way that's actually not terrible. Okay, I'm gonna go damage. Can I go damage, please? Don't mold and oh, damn. Wait, they sacked it to it. Ah, okay. I guess I should have then sacked my Hogaak to that to then to trade. That would have been a way that I didn't die here. Well, I'm glad I thought of that after the fact. That would have been so sick as well. I would have got him, but I didn't do that. So it's not so sick. It's actually the opposite of being sick. It's kind of lame. Well, let's hope they just don't do it. Let's just hope they totally blank on the key interaction of their own deck. Yeah, I should have sacked my Hogaak there. That would have been really good. Well, actually, no, because then they would have just sacked another artifact and they would have just... would have ended up with the same situation, but with a 4-4 Arcbound Ravager. So it would have happened. But keeping my mana up at least pretends that we might have some sort of interaction. We're casting a favorite looting, although digging to get something for next turn doesn't really get us there. Okay, they... Wait. Activate this. Don't have to say anything? No. Activate this. Put these kettles on there. After we've Pendlehavened it. Kill me. Yeah, okay. Our opponent was nice enough to give us a win. That doesn't make me feel small at all. On to the next round. We have won this die roll in round 5. Hobo DM is our opponent. We're going to go first. We've got a pretty terrible hand, so we cannot keep that. If that was a red source, this is why we don't play too many swamps, I guess, right? But if that was a red source, this would be keepable, I think. Two lootings, a bridge from below. Yeah, this is fine. Get our second land, a creature, and we're carving it up. No, we don't want that, though. Get rid of that bad boy. We don't want a second Hogaak. No way. Okay. Let's play looting. And say yes. Because I love the pain, me. I love the pain. We're going to cast Faithless Looting. We're going to put Bridge from Below and Bloodghast in our graveyard. Okay, cool. Not a bad start. Not a bad start at all. We get to loot and play Bloodghast next turn. Or we get to play Ultra Dimension and Bloodghast next turn. I think I'll loot before playing a land in case we hit second Bloodghast, I think. Or if we hit an untapped. If we hit a non-fetch land as well, because fetch land allows us to make multiple Bloodghasts. Fiery Islet into Aether Vial. I have no idea what this is. Slivers, perhaps? Or maybe... Ugh, just don't know. That's pretty weird. Red-blue Merfolk? Okay, so we draw a land. We play Faithless Looting. Yeah. We find Vengevine and Hogaak. Well, Vengevine and Blackcleave, but the cards could have been a Vengevine and Hogaak. Okay, let's do that. Let's play a Blackcleave. Get this back. Say yes. And then pass the turn. Next turn, we're going to start milling ourselves. Go ahead, blue red vile deck man. Person. Nothing in chat. Nothing to be like, hey, I'm playing weird stuff. Fiery Islet. I really like the art for it. I don't like the name. It just sounds like... It reminds me of Isla Fisher, is it? The actor married to Sacha Baron Cohen. Like that. But they're fiery. They're a redhead. They could play Chandra. Aether Vial number 2 with the strictly worse art. It looks like a spinning top more so than an Aether Vial, but whatever. Whatever. On top, draw a Faithless Looting. Okay. Let's go Altar of Dementia. What could? Nope, nothing from them. Okay, let's go ahead and sack this to this. Hopefully, hitting a bridge. We've only got one bridge in the bin, but a second would be a lovely. Viling in. What one drop could really mess with our plans here? A benthic biomancer is blue red merfolk. Interesting. Okay. Mill us for 2. A second Bloodghast. That's pretty nice here. Always yes to this. Come on, let's crack on. I would have said always yes, but whatever. Let's mill ourselves again. More zombos, more mill. 3 venge rounds in the graveyard. Should have found some one drops for next turn. Another bridge. Cool. Let's go and get a blood crypt to pay the life because we want to cast Faithless this turn. Always yes, please. Yes. Yeah, oh god, Bennett. Modo, why'd you do these things to me, Modo? Let's go ahead and cast Faithless Looting. I don't think they're going to get to untap this turn. I think they're dead on turn three. Ditch this. No, not this. Yeah, this and this, I guess. Then we're going to go ahead and sack, targeting ourselves for the Bloodghast. Oh, I should have tapped them first for the Hogaak, actually. Let's do that. Cast this with these. You shouldn't be sacking untapped creatures in this deck if you can help it, I think, if you want to be efficient. Then we get rid of Carrion Feeder, Stitcher, Stitcher, Verdant, Swamp. Okay. Then we're going to sack this, mill ourselves for 8. Always yield to these bad boys. I love that old Bridge Below art. So D&D. Okay, there we go. And then we're going to go sack. Have we hit another bridge yet? Because there's faster things to do is get bridges. No, it doesn't. So let's go cast this again. And then once we cast that, we're going to go Bloodstained Mire, Polluted Delta, Necrotic Wound, Insolent Neonate, Insolent Neonate. Get some Vengevines back. Yeah, they don't get to untap. Okay, they have scooped. They have scooped. Because we're going to then just mill them out, I think. Yeah, just target all the mill at their face. Might have to cycle Hogaak back into play one more time, perhaps. Red, Blue, Merfolk. I'm expecting Cages and Aether Vials. Let's get these bad boys in here. Let's get Crypt Breaker in as well. Drop 2 Ghast. 1 Insolent and 1 Vengevine, maybe? Nah, it's still pretty good. Probably want the wounds. Nah, we don't want wounds. We'll go faster than them. Wound is for hate bears and like disruptive creatures like scavenging ewes, for example. It's not for 4/4 Merfolk Lords. They can just do whatever they want as long as we're killing them faster, I guess. And that's kind of the mantra of modern, right? Do whatever you want as long as I'm killing you faster. Yeah. Yeah. Red, blue, Merfolk. What the hell does red even give them? Sorry, I was just reading Twitter while I wait. Probably shouldn't do that. Probably should talk to you, right? Yeah, so not really sure what red's going to give him. Bolts, perhaps? Okay, it's a one lander, but it's got an Ingot Chewer. You can block their vial. It's got into the Neonate as well. I'm going to risk this. I don't think I should risk this if I was really playing competitively. Well, glad I kept it now. God, that ult, that art's cool as well. So we're just going to go, like, Neonate first, I guess. Well, we don't want to get our Ingot Chew account. Oh, no, Ingot Chew is a creature. I can't even get countered by the typical, like, Merfolk nonsense. Would I pay 2? Yes, I will. Let's make a Neonate. Then we can discard a Bloodghast to our Neonate and Ingot Chew the Graft Digger's Cage. The turn. Oh, we're going to go with getting with the cage first, I guess. That would make sense. Fairy Conclave. That is not what red adds, but that's an interesting addition to the deck. Maybe it's not Merfolk. Maybe it's like tempo of some kind. Let's just blow up this Grafdigger's Cage then. What mana spell could possibly stop my powerful Ingot Chewer? No spell pierce for you, my friend. There we go, there we go. And we could sack it to our what'd you call it? The black one drop if it was in play, but it's not. And we're gonna discard a card, draw a card. Please don't draw bridge. Okay, so yes. Close to Hogaak mana already. Crack this. Actually, we have Hogaak mana if we just make a Stitcher now and then mill ourselves a load and then delve the 8-8 into play. That seems pretty good. Like, Vapor Snag would be a pain, but whatever. Let's go black. Turn 2, 8-8 seems strong. I wouldn't lie to you. We left a Grave Caller in our graveyard as well. Okay. So next turn we're swinging for 11. Or just trying to go off with Alter, actually. That's the other option. Combo killing them. There's the Fiery Islet. Maybe it's just Merfolk with the Islet for the card draw. Maybe I'm getting too bogged down with this Red Splash. Oh, look. We're going lower than Atlantis to just randomly say a band's name in a sentence. Okay. Do they have a Spell Pierce? That is the question I'm asking them. Do you have a Spell Pierce, sir? Or Spell Snare, sir? I mean, it would mean that we can't just kill them, but... Force of Negation! Woof! Okay, that's sick. Modern Horizon cards on both sides of the field. Everyone said it was Commander Masters, but they were lying. They knew not of what they spoke. Okay, let's get in. Did they block the Stitcher Supply here, or did they take it? That's an interesting point. No, they block it. They want to save themselves one damage, I guess. Vengevine to the graveyard. Sweet. Next turn we get to make a Vengevine. Vengevine's a fun magic card to trigger and put into play. I will say that. I prefer the original art than that art. That art looks too, like, round-headed in my opinion. It looks like a spaceship or a sports car, like a Ferrari. I guess it does have haste. If a Ferrari was a creature, it would be a 4-3 with haste, right? I feel really sorry when the deck does do well, because, like, this player is just trying to play this, like, new version of Merfolk, and here we are. We're going to make a Vengevine. That's lame. I mean, they might just be dead anyway. Yeah, they're dead anyway, unless that blue mana is a Vapor Snag. Surprise! It's another Bloodgast. In we go. Where will we stop? Well, in their face, that's where we'll stop. Yeah, the deck doesn't feel very fair. So we went 3-2 in the end. Can I go back to see that? Oh, whatever. I hope you enjoy the video. Me getting absolutely wrecked on turns 3 and 4 by other decks. Or just getting, like, you know, just screwed out a little bit by things like Tron. Hate cards are pretty good against us, as you can see. Sometimes our opponents just don't do anything, though. We just steamroll them because we're so fast. We're one of those decks. This deck is similar to Burn, similar to Dredge. Just, if you don't have a piece of hate, then you just get steamrolled the majority of the time. I think the deck is actually better than this showing has shown. I think I got a bit unlucky with some of my hands, I guess. And also, the meta game's a bit more prepared for it. As you saw, there's a lot of sideboard hate floating around, some of it being mainboard. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you thought in the comment section below. I'm sure some of you can tell me how bad I am at the deck, and that's cool. That's cool. If that's your prerogative, if that floats your proverbial boat, then float that boat down the river, my friend. I'm Vince, I'm the Pleasant Kenobi on the internet. Check me out on youtube.com/PleasantKenobi. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel as well and like this video if you enjoyed it, because it helps out a lot. And I'll see you all very, very soon. Ta-ta for now.